God, it will be over here. He's always telling mom and everybody else, God's got my back. And during all this, you taught me that God does got your back. And that will help us make it through this. I know you're having God walking beside you, touching your heart and spirit to reassure us it's okay because God got your back. I want to read and let you know, Dad, I love you and will miss you, but also rejoice because I know you're with the Lord and he rules heaven. Dad, you are one true rock, a shoulder in which I rely on whenever I was angry or when I needed to cry. You're the strongest man I ever knew. But when I saw him at the hospital, all I heard was, there's no chance. The doctor said, no matter what we could do or what we could say, we couldn't make you stay. Unresponsive, unable to speak, unable to feel anything but pain, everything they could do would be in vain. Stop all the tests we ordered. Keep them as comfortable as can be. As hard as it was for us, we had to set them free. Over the last days, you slowly drifted, but all that we could do was hold your hand and cry. For here is this man, the strongest man I ever knew. I couldn't figure out how we would survive in this crazy world without you. As you took your final breath, tears formed in our eyes. As hard as it was for us, it was hard for you to say goodbye. God said it was your time, so slowly picked up your hand. So slowly you picked up your hands and held them to the sky. Final breath, and just like that, you were gone. We know you're with God now, and it's going to be free. When we get to heaven, we will all get to see your smiling face, laughing, walking pain-free. We will get to say, I love you. We'll be as happy as we can be. And so that we will miss you more and more each day. No matter what we'll do, this world is far a lonelier place without you. I love you, Dad. Miss you more than you ever know. As much as this hurts me, I'm letting you go.
Amen.